I'm beating a dead horse. I've always said this. They've never been the same since they lost that Super Bowl to the New England Patriots. It was not because they
lost. You have been consistent.
It was not because they lost. It was not that they lost. It was how they lost. They decided that day, Pete Carroll and Darrell Bevell, we're going to make Russell Wilson the hero when it was clear that the momentum was flowing with beast mode Marshawn Lynch. The defense had done its job. Seattle was marching down the field. Fly pattern left-hand side to Marshawn Lynch. He skates down the sideline. Then all of a sudden, you know, and then ultimately he ends up running from the four-yard line to the one-half-yard line. And then they decide they're going to try to throw a pass over the middle. In the eyes of some of those players, you were trying to make Russell Wilson a hero. Now, let's be clear about something here. Russell Wilson is spectacular as far as I'm concerned. He's a big-time football player. I got a lot of love for him. He's been worthy of MVP considerations at least a couple of times in his career. We know that he's the face of that franchise, and he's a really good dude, too, by the way. But you do have a lot of rough riders on there that saw the willingness of the organization to sort of cater to Russell Wilson. The interesting part is, Ryan, they haven't done that when it comes to that offensive line of his. Mm-hmm. Because clearly they haven't invested enough in that offensive line. They haven't been the same since they lost Max Unger a few years ago. They haven't been the same as an offensive line. And when you look at the pressure that was applied to him, you finally realize once again that Russell Wilson, year after year after year, is playing with smoke and mirrors and just up against a tsunami, for crying out loud. Yesterday it was Khalil Mack and the crew. Khalil Mack, once again, absolutely spectacular. We're talking about the era from Butkus to Ditka to Singletary to Urlacher, and now we've got the Mack era. This is what it's all about right now, and we get all of that. But what you're seeing from the Seattle Seahawks is the same old, same old. A good team that's not great because Russell Wilson has to do too much, usually running for his life. That's what this comes down to, Ryan. Max.
Look, that is an easy story to tell. They wanted Russell Wilson to be the hero, and so it all fell apart after that because it didn't work. And you've been telling that story, Stephen A., and I believe that former players on the Seahawks believe that story.
That's what they told me.
But then there is, there is reality. And you hit on it the first point. When they made the Max Unger for Jimmy Graham deal, the offensive line fell apart. It has not been the same since. Russell Wilson's been running for his life and doing, by the way, a pretty fair Aaron Rodgers impersonation. He's not Aaron Rodgers, but he's sort of a poor man's Aaron Rodgers as a one-man offense. Okay, two, we had this argument a couple years ago. Do you trade the Seahawks' defensive stars? And I argued, yes, you do. Because you have, like, as Belichick does, you trade a year too early when the player still has value rather than a year too late where you just kind of got to offload those contracts. The Seahawks made up their mind. We're going to hold on to these guys. We're going to try to make another run with what was the previous generations in the NFL, generations 3, 4, 5 years for a defense, the previous generations' generational defense. And that was, in retrospect, a mistake. I thought it was a mistake at the time. And finally, when you pay a quarterback top dollar, which they have done with Russell Wilson, you do not have the money to address other areas of need. I love when I hear, well, the next quarterback up, he's got to set the market for the players, for the players. It's not for the players. It's for the quarterbacks. There's a finite amount of money. If the quarterback gets $1 more, some other position gets $1 less. Every dollar you spend on one position is a dollar you can't spend elsewhere. That's the way it works. And the Seahawks gave Russell Wilson a bunch of money, and they didn't even hedge their bets by trading the defense when they could have gotten real value back for them. That's what's happening to the Seattle Seahawks. I didn't think they were a playoff team coming into this year. That's exactly what it looks like right now.
Well, you guys make some interesting points. And obviously, what happened in the Super Bowl, not giving the ball to Marshawn Lynch, that has something to do with the attitude of the team. At that time, you still have to go out and play football. And the Legion of Boom was still together. This defense was still the defense that could get after the passer with four and play defense on the back end with seven. And it wasn't about making Russell Wilson the hero of that game. It was this team starting to switch the mindset offensively that Russell Wilson was going to be the focal point and not Marshawn Lynch. That is why the Max Unger longer trade happen because you thought, let me get Russell Wilson another weapon on the outside. Let me get him somebody that is a red zone target instead of protecting him up front. So these decisions started to come down from Pete Carroll, from the GM, John Snyder, and that is why we have seen this team slip. The other thing that goes overlooked here was that this team was very, very good at getting late draft picks that turned out to be stars. Russell Wilson as a third-round quarterback, you aren't expecting that. To get a guy like Richard Sherman in the fifth round who becomes an all-pro corner, Cam Chancellor, who is a pro bowler, drafted in the late rounds. When you have guys like that hit, making a decision to bring in Michael Bennett when he wasn't a star before he got to Seattle, Bobby Wagner, a second-round pick, when you have these guys become better than what they're drafted at, better than what they were projected to be, this is how you get value young and value early. And as these guys started to age and they received the accolades that they did, now you had to pay them money. And you weren't hitting on those late picks. Byron Maxwell wasn't really what you thought he was. And now so you're playing with guys that are who they are. You aren't getting lucky that you're getting late round picks to be great players. And so when you change your mindset, that takes you away from the physicality that made you great, and you start to make bad decisions, which is what's happened with Pete Carroll and Snyder, this is where you find yourself without the players to do it.
I'm not challenging anything that you say, but what I'm doing is trying to add to it from this perspective. You talk about the change in identity, okay? First of all, they were focused on defense more so, and then after they got Russell Wilson, they tried to focus a little bit on offense. So I get that part. But the reason why I bring so much attention to what happened in that Super Bowl, because it was at that moment that the change, they tried to implement it. Mm-hmm. That ain't the moment for that. That's number one, which is what a lot of players lamented. Number two, and more importantly, let's think about that for a second here. When you talk about the mindset of players, well, you're looking at a situation where Pete Carroll and those guys, it wasn't just their picks. It was the mindset that they supported.